And you won't understand it until you actually go and do it.
And here we go.
Oh, I totally understand it. Until you actually get underneath 500 plus pounds and realize, oh shit, I could possibly die. This shit is real. There's something fucked up with us that we are addicted to this pain and pleasure and can't live without it. I can't wait to get back up into the 600 club and the 500 clubs and the fucking 900 pound clubs. You know what I'm saying? I can't wait to hit that again, right? And I'm determined to do it. I'm not gonna die again unless I'm gonna do it. And if I die, they'll never be able to say, Tiny wasn't trying his best. I'm doing my best to get back to my level, right? I still wanna be in a fucking animal cage. I still wanna fucking get the world record for the fucking squat. At 40 fucking years old, I still got all these fucking goals, and that's my fucking plan. And I'm gonna fucking do it, right? There's no reason why I can't do this. The only reason I can stop is because I say, oh, I wanna quit. And that isn't in my blood to fucking quit. That's not in my blood. My blood is strong. My blood is unique. That's what we need to realize. Realize who you are and where you wanna be and where you wanna go and fucking kill it. I just spoke for 10 minutes. I didn't mean to do this, right? But I just had to let you know, it's fucking, this shit is hard. Mentally, this is fucking hard. Mentally, I'm just like, oh my gosh. Like, every day I wake up not as strong as I was before. And every day I wake up like, damn, I gotta get stronger. I gotta get, you know, healthier for my children. I need my strength back. Every day I'm facing that shit. I want to be strong for my wife. I want to be a role model for people, you know, for kids.
Some people do this shit for fun. He do this shit because this is his job.
Huh?
This your job. Look at that. He got one leg. Look at this shit. Look, I don't know about my finger pointing. One leg, look, right there. Listen, this is how you know he's serious.
Or stupid.
Yo. Fuck with him. Strongest motivation person. No, I don't.
I want him to realize that no matter what the fuck is thrown in your fucking face, that you can crush anything. And death can't even keep me down. That's what I'm trying to prove. That death can't even stop me. Death can't even capture. I'm trying to be like my fucking mom. My mom was a motherfucking death. Death tried to get her every motherfucking minute, right? Heart attacks. Right? Let's open your chest up and cut your heart all up. Heart attack. Death tried his best to get my mom. I'm trying to live like my mom. Right? Death tried his best to get my dad a few times. But that nigga was just ignorant and rude and big. He said, fuck you. And that's the type of bloodline I have. And that's what I need to carry on. That's what I need to instill in my children. Death, you can't even fuck me. I can't fucking die. I will not die. I refuse to fucking die. I'm not gonna die unhealthy. I don't want that. I wanna die with 1,000 pounds on my back. 1,200 pounds, my bad. 1,200 pounds on my back. And it crushed me. And I attacked it hard as fuck. But yeah, that motherfucker, he got me. We're gonna get this shit.
If you wanna stop me, you're gonna have to fucking kill me!
I almost died.
I don't do this for the riches, I'm infected, my condition is I'm always in my head. These words are my religion, I'm obsessed, it's by decision, I'ma do this till I'm dead, yeah. Set me on fire, whoa, whoa. I'm still alive, whoa.
But you didn't think that I'd come back to life.
Pulling up to motherfucking Garden State right the fuck now in order to get this workout in. So, I love you motherfuckers. Everybody reach your fucking goals and keep on going forward. Alright? No matter what the fuck happens to me, I love you motherfuckers.